OCA Media Sports is proud to bring you this exciting Panther volleyball match. Tonight, live from the Oregon High School Gymnasium, the Oregon Panthers will host the Beaver Dam Golden Beavers. I am Ben Baker with my host, Mike Stapleman, who is currently down on the floor doing announcements, and I thank that very much from him. I will be bringing you all of tonight's exciting Panther volleyball action. We would like to welcome our local partners whose financial support helps make this broadcast possible. The Village of Oregon, a great place to live, work, and play. The Oregon School District, actively building competency, character, culture, and community. The Oregon Athletic Booster Club, supporting student athletes in all Panther sports. Be a part of something great. Culver's of Oregon, Stoughton Health, J.L. Richards Prime Meats, Hy-Vee Grocery Store, the Oregon Area Cares Community Coalition, and by Pizza Pits. Next, we have Beaver Dam on the court doing some warm-ups, and we have Oregon on the side just doing some drills. So, excited for a great game.
High School for today's Badger Conference matchup between the Golden Beavers of Beaver Dam and your Oregon Panthers! Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, to honor America, would you please rise if able, remove your hats, and join in singing our national anthem. Oregon High School and the WIAA require good sportsmanship by student-athletes, coaches, and spectators at education-based interscholastic events. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Profanity, racial, sexist, or ethnic comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student-athletes, coaches, or team representatives will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the site of competition. On behalf of Oregon Athletic Director Brittany Spencer Grant, good luck to all coaches and competitors. We hope everyone will enjoy today's event in the spirit of positive sportsmanship. Also, thank you to tonight's officials, Dave Schwanke and Kevin Lupker. Thank you for your continued efforts in supporting high school athletics. And now here are your starting lineups. First for the visitors from Beaver Dam. Number 6, Kira Sanders. Number 10, Amaya Jackson. Number 12, Kendall Fakes. Number 14, Addison Dow. Number 16, Jalen Dronick. Number 20, Emma Jolke. And at libero, number 4, Alexis Sobrilski. Beaver Dam is coached by Tegan Pickards. And now for your Oregon Panthers! Number 5, Ava Dibovic-Skripka! Number 7, Greta Schriever! Number 8, Evie LeVay! Number 9, McKenna Carroll! Number 11, Maya Rui! Number 15, Sophie Sai! And your libero, number 2, Lex Fields! The Panthers are coached by Jennifer Grolke.
If your organization would like to join our group of sponsors who make Panther sports possible, please contact paul@ocamedia.com for more information. Beaver Dam to serve. Riley Kennedy with the serve. Up and over the net, number 20. And that is going to be out on Beaver Dam Point, Oregon. Greta Schriever with the serve. Ball looks good, mixed over the net. Drop. Oh, over the net. Number three. Bumps it. Number 10, attempted spike. Saved by Oregon number six, Jada Anderson. She's able to make it back over. With a spike, Oregon lost that Beaver point.
Good evening, Ben. How are things looking up here?
Looking great so far, except for the fact that it's currently a tie game. We're 14 to serve. Five's able to make it.
Good evening, everyone. This is Mike joining Ben up here in the OCA media booth. I think he got you guys started off, but just a reminder, we're here in Oregon High School as the Oregon Panthers take on the Beaver Dam Golden Beavers. Got a little bit of a new setup up here. Got new soundboard, new partner setup.
Everything is great so far.
Exciting night. Sophie Tsai with the touch at the net. Ava sets out to Maya. Roll shot over. Golden Beaver's able to get it up. Sophie Tsai with the tip of the net pushes it down. Good. Panthers up. 3-1. Alexis Fields back to serve. Oh, Alexis Fields with the tough serve into the corner. Picked up by number 10, Amaya Jackson from Beaver Dam, but sent out of bounds. Another ace for the Panthers. Alexis Fields with the serve. Another one that's trouble. Number 20, Emma Jolke, the center for Beaver Dam. Goes into the net, trying to bring that one back. That'll be another point for the Panthers. And Alexis Fields keeps it up at the service line.
Serve looked really good.
Oh. Okay, so that one was rolled over by number 10, Amaya Jackson from Beaver Dam. Alexis Fields picked it up in the back, but unfortunately not able to keep that pass in bounds. Went over for a Beaver Dam point. Number 7, Gabby Fakes is subbed in for Beaver Dam with the serve. Greta Schriever with the receive. Maya Rudy with the swing. No touch, just out. Be a point, Beaver Dam.
Score stands 5 Oregon, 3 Beaver Dam. Evelyn Lavoie.
Oh, no. No touch called, so that'll be 4 on the Panthers. Swing did not get over the net, unfortunately.
Number 7, Gabby Fakes serve.
Alexis Fields with the receive. Sets over to Sophie Tsai and a big kill right into the middle.
That looked amazing from up here.
Yep, that was a really nice pass. Good decision by Ava with the set there. Set to Sophie again. That one caught up in the Beaver Dam block and down on the Beaver Dam side, so that'll be a point for the Panthers. So with a couple of subs, yeah. JC subs in, as well as Rachel Cook. Panthers are running a bit of a unique offense right now. They're running a 5-2. Oh, Sophie Side with the big block. One thing I'd like to call out is with the tournament the Panthers were in this past weekend, Sophie Sy is currently the career leader in Oregon High School with blocks. Or at least in the modern era, since we've been keeping stats at the level we are. Hey, that's an ace by Rachel Cook. Panthers push the lead to 8-5. Sophie Sy, I think, at 23 blocks on the season so far. And we'll use the rest of the year to keep pushing that number higher. And then as a reminder, she's just a junior, so she's got a full year to keep building that number up. Oh, Rachel Cook with the dig. But Panthers not able to get it up to the center. So that'll be Beaver Dam point. Amaya Jackson back to serve. So right now we've got JC Andrew, Sophie Sy, Evelyn Lavoie, Rachel Cook, Greta Schriever, and Alexis Fields out there. Greta with the swing. Panther block was there. Oh, nice play by Sophie to keep that one alive. Overpass. JC Andrew was able to get a hand on it, but not put it back. Block stuck up on the net. Greta Schriever has to scramble to keep it up. Oh, Beaver Dam with the setter dump. Beaver Dam pulls within one, 8-7 here in set number one. Greta Schriever with the receive. Called for a double. We're tied up here in set number one, 8-8. That pass is out of bounds. Good call by my partner up here, Ben, and the Panther back line. If your organization would like to join our group of sponsors who make Panther sports possible, please contact Paul at osammedia.com for more information. Certainly is nice, the setup we've got up here and the ability for us to bring you live Panther sports. Oh, that one might have been going out of bounds, but Jackson brings it in. Roll shot blocked by Sophie Sy, adding to that career total.
That number is going to keep on going up this season, isn't it?
Certainly is. Dev Howard back to serve. Another long serve. Oh, just out of bounds.
I'm not going to lie. I couldn't tell up here if that was going to be inbounds or outbounds.
Yeah, it's a different angle. That one was pretty close to take, but she was confident in her position, so let it go by her. Dev Howard with the pat. Beautiful. Whoa. Sets up to Greta Schriever, not able to get the ball over.
Number four, Alexis Saborski. How do you say that one again? Saborski?
Sabrilski.
Sabrilski to serve.
Greta Schriever with the roll shot off the net. Not able to get that one over either. It'll be another point Beaver Dam. And after a really tight first set, Beaver Dam with what feels like their first lead of the night. They're now up 11-10 here in set number one. Dev Howard with the take. Greta Schriever, that's three in a row that have hit the exact same spot on the net, not getting them over. Mm-hmm. So if you look at the Panthers, you see JC Andrew, number 10, is our setter in the front row. Setter dump picked up by Sabrilski. That one out of bounds, no touch. That'll be a point to the Panthers. And what we had been running earlier in the year was a 6-2 where our setters would always come out of the back row. So Ava and JC would swap into the back row. And now what we do, oh, there's an ace for Sophie Side. Now Ava sets from the back row, and then when she rotates up to the front, we sub her out and we put JC Andrew in. And so we're still getting the two setters because the Panthers have two good setters and you want to get them both playtime. But JC's also got good timing and good reach on that block. And it gets her some run in the front row. Also gives her the ability. That one's out. Oh, that one's out. That's a tight call.
Yeah. Alexis Fields is would be going in for number 15, Sophie Tisa?
Sai.
Sai.
Yep, and so that's the libero exchange. Alexis Fields replaces our middle Sophie Sai going into the back row. Greta Schriever with the take. Pass outside. McKenna Carroll not able to get an attack on it. Beaver Dam not able to get an attack on it. JC Andrew sets outside to Greta Schriever. It's called for a double. It's tight calls tonight. So the Panthers are running, like I said, kind of a non-traditional offense with one setter setting out of the front row, one setter setting out of the back row. Panthers have liked it the last couple of matches they've used it. They rolled it out at the Middleton Invitational this weekend. JC Andrew tries to setter dump that one over, not able to get it over. Panthers down three here, 15-12 in the first set.
Number 20, Emma Juka to serve.
Greta Schriever with the swing. Gets that one down. There we go. And so now you'll see JC Andrew subs out of the front row. And Ava Dibovic-Skripka will come into the position number one and serve. And Maya Rudy replaces number four, Rachel Cook. Oh, there we go. Another ace for Ava. Interesting in a two-setter system. You know, you're splitting a lot of stats. Ava's already up to 100 assists here this year. Oh, there's another ace. Oh. And she pulls us tight. 15-15 in set number one. Oh, there's another one.
Wow.
I wish I had Ava's ace numbers up here. I didn't think to bring them tonight. We've got a couple of players racking up the aces. And Beaver Dam with their first time out of the night as the Panthers take the lead, 16-15.
So, Mike, you've been a bit more involved in volleyball than I have. Sorry. This year, can you tell me just a bit on how their season's been showing out their play style?
Yeah. Well, it's been a pretty good season. One thing that's interesting about the Panthers is we definitely were replacing a lot of, a lot of big pieces from last year. We've got a lot of younger players, a lot of sophomores getting a lot of run this year. You know, JC Andrew, one of our setters, Evie Lavoie, who we've seen a bunch as a sophomore out there, Rachel Cook, Dev Howard, and Alexis Fields are all Rachel Cook's a junior.
Yes.
Dev Howard and Alexis Fields are sophomores. So it's a young team. Definitely learned a few lessons as a young team, and then with some different offenses. So far, the Panthers are 5-5. They had a match against Watertown and Monona Grove since we last spoke. Actually, I think I announced the Watertown match. So it was a game against Monona Grove. They lost that, and then they went 2-2 at the Middleton Invitational this past weekend with some matches against some really tough teams. So it's been a fun start to the season. Oh, that's an overpass. Ava has to run up and grab that. So setters out way across the court for Maya.
Save there. Over the net. Diving catch by Howard.
Out. Middle tried to tip it over and find that corner. And went out of bounds. Ava back to serve. Boy, and actually it looks like... So I was trying to find some information on Beaver Dam earlier this week, and it was devilishly difficult. And actually, I believe looks like they updated Max Preps today.
Yep.
So I think they are 9-9 overall. And 0-2 in their conference matchups. Panthers are 5-5. Oh, get over. Ava with another ace. And I think Ava came in at 15-13 and is now 19-15, so she's been on quite the tear.
Yes.
Four of those points is aces. Get down. Nope.
Oh, out.
So 19-16 here in set number one. Beaver Dam with the serve. Kara Sanders in the serve for Beaver Dam. One of the things that I thought was interesting about the Beaver Dam team is they're also young. I saw they've got two freshmen on varsity and they've got three sophomores, if I counted right. One of the freshmen is starting. Oh, big block by McKenna Carroll. McKenna Carroll's got 14 blocks this year already, so that's 15. Last year she had 33 in the whole season. So it's shaping up to be a good senior year for McKenna Carroll. Yeah, and as I said earlier, Sophie Sy came in tonight with 22 blocks on the year. Another big block. Beaver Dam able to recover, send it over. Set out to Maya Rudy. Got one, kind of got hung up in the net and put the libero in a weird spot. She wasn't able to dig it up. Panthers push the lead 21-16, and Beaver Dam needs their second time out of the first set. So I think another thing that's interesting about this year is we're seeing conference realignment. So we've seen the Badger Conference go through a handful of iterations in the last decade. What we're doing this year is Badger Small and Badger Large, and it's the Panthers' first year in Badger Large. So they're going to see some teams that they haven't seen historically over the years. Also probably going to see some teams with, you know, maybe a higher level of competition than you typically see come into Oregon High School. We'll have to get used to that. I think the Panthers are ready for it.
I agree.
So when we come back, 21-16, Panthers with a 5-point lead here in set number one over the Beaver Dam Golden Beavers. Boy, Beaver Dam must have played in a bunch of weekend tournaments to have be 9-9 already. Yes. I feel like the Panthers play every weekend. They're 5-5. But they primarily play in one-day tournaments. Maybe Beaver Dam visited some two-day tournaments, Saturday and Sundays.
Was the Monroe invite, was that 2 days or one?
I'm not sure. I wasn't invited. Oh, that's a touch on the net. Out of bounds. Point Beaver Dam. McKenna Carroll and Meyer were there. That was another thing the team was really focusing on at the Middleton Invitational. They were getting a lot of touches up on the net and then working on really bringing it back into the court, not only pressing over but, you know, bringing the ball into the court as opposed to letting it bang off you out of bounds. Now a quick set to McKenna Carroll. That one's out of bounds. The Panthers have two really aggressive setters, Ava and JC, are really aggressive, and even on kind of mediocre passes, they are looking to score, and they're looking to score all across the net. Panthers have not really found the rhythm on the quicks to the middle so far this year, and we've got two great middles. Maya Rudy puts that one down the line. Boy, when Maya's swinging, she is swinging. What a play. Ava put her in a position to succeed, put her in a position to score, and Maya took advantage. Alexis Fields back to serve, 23-17 here in set number one. Oh, Alexis brings that one back. That's in trouble, though. There we go. Evie Lavoie goes to put that one down. That's trouble. Pass into the net. Beaver Dam able to recover. Greta Schriever sets Maya. Oh. Kind of took her foot off the gas on that and just went to pass it over and didn't make it. So if we rewind a little bit, That was an amazing up in the back by Alexis Fields. The Panthers have a legit libero here in sophomore Lex Fields. Sophie Tsai with the tip. Beaver Dam able to get it up. Evie Lavoie set in the corner. Able to push to that deep corner. Kira Sanders not able to handle it. And that'll bring us to set point. JC Andrew subs in. And Rachel Cook will replace Maya Rudy and go back to serve.
Please correct me if I am wrong, but we only need one more point or set.
Yep, we played a 25 per set. Tough serve by Rachel Cook. Be a roll shot coming over. Greta Shriver's all over that. JC sets up. Well, I don't know if that was to Sophie Tsai or Evie Lavoie. A little bit of half and half. And that doesn't work. So senior outside, Amaya Jackson is back to serve for Beaver Dam. We've got a handful of set points coming up. Greta Shriver sets out to Rachel Cook, who's playing back row, so wasn't able to jump and attack that one. And we'll try set point number three here. Panthers got to take a deep breath. Evie Lavoie with the swing and the kill. And that brings us to the end of set number one. Panthers take it 25-20. If you're new to volleyball, we play best of five. First team to win three wins. And if we go to a fifth set, then you play to 15. And you got to win by two. That's how one of the Panthers sets at the Middleton Invitational was 18-16 because they got to 15-15 and then just kept trading points.
If your organization would like to join our group of sponsors who make Panther sports possible, please contact Paul at ocamedia.com for more information.
And let's give a hand at home to our Oregon dance team who's come out to support the volleyball team tonight. So we'll see if the Panthers make any changes to their lineup here in set number two. I'm not really expecting any, but some of these conference matches, it can be an opportunity to try out some different alignments or try girls in different positions, especially with as many young players as we have. You know, give them a look at a different position. Now, it's hard to compare stats from team to team. Not every team stats the same. Not every team updates their stats. But Alexis Fields, like I said, she's a sophomore playing libero this year. And I feel like she's a real deal. She's up to 84 digs so far this year and 3.5 digs per set. And especially in the last couple of matches, she really is just flying all over the court. She has been making diving saves in the back row. And then they're not just getting, you know, she's not just getting her hands on them. Like the one in that last set, she's diving and then getting it straight to the setter so the Panthers can put an attack on it. So, Ben, I hear you've announced other events for OCA Media.
Yes, I enjoy doing basketball lots. It's probably one of my favorite sports to do, but I'm currently doing volleyball, so that way I can do just a bit more work on my announcing. And honestly, I do think it's a great sport. It's always fun to see competition at any sport, any level. I love to see what Oregon does for their athletics teams. It is cool to see the improvement that we've done throughout the years, and it is even cooler to see the improvement play out right in front of you. So,
yep. Yeah. Panthers have definitely had you know, they've been getting better over the last 5 years as Coach Grokey has taken over this varsity program. Not sure exactly what kind of end result we're going to have this year, you know, we had a really good season last year, ended 21-17. But again, you lose some of those senior leaders and restock with sophomores. You know, they're learning some lessons here at the varsity level, but you're also taking a look at this team and thinking, man, that's going to be a lot of strong juniors coming back. All right, and we're off in set number two as Ava gets us started. Dev Howard. All right, Maya Rudy hits into the block. Falls down on the Panther side. Beaver Dam gets us started with 1 point. Kara Sanders will be back to serve for the Golden Beavers. Whoa! Ooh. Quick set to McKenna Carroll. She's got a lot of power. That one ended up being pretty much a line drive to that back line, but not able to find the back line, and it didn't hit any Golden Beavers. So that's a point. Alexis Fields with a little bit of a misplay. Dev Howard sets it up to Greta Schriever. Greta with the whoa, swing, a little bit out of system.
Into the audience on that one.
Yeah, but banged it off Alexis Sobrilski for the first Panther point of set number two. Greta's having an interesting season. She was the libero last year, but taking a look at the strengths of this team, Panthers definitely needed some swings from outside. And so Greta transitioned to an outside hitter. So as that one's out. Last year, Greta had 412 digs and 564 receptions and serve receive, had a 91% passing percentage, was really good at that back row with that libero jersey on. This year she's got 64 kills, and I think she's leading the team in, whoops, I think she's leading the team in kills per set, and she's got 58 digs herself. And then that serve isn't a good example of it, but she's also leading the team in aces, and she's racking up just under one ace a set. She's got 20 aces so far this year. Greta passes it out to Evelyn Lavoy.
Oh.
That definitely hit 20, but no call.
Fortunate. So, Mike, is there anything that this season has just really surprised you with, like player-wise, maybe just stats as well?
It's been interesting to see the various ways Coach Grokey is working her two setters in. A lot of teams have one setter and they play all the way around, but when you've got when you've got a senior leader like Ava, and then you've got a sophomore who's ready to play like JC, you need to find a way to balance it out. And, you know, trying the 6-2 and trying the 5-2. McKenna Carroll with the swing, not able to get that over the net. Panthers are digging themselves a little bit of a hole here in set number two, currently down 6-2.
However, Alexis Fields has not been afraid to dive tonight whatsoever.
Nope, and if you are afraid to dive, you probably shouldn't be wearing the libero jersey. This is Addison Dow back there at the service line for the Panthers, or for the Golden Beavers. And Coach Grokey needs a timeout. This set has not started the way the Panthers were hoping.
Yes.
You know, and I think we'll learn some other lessons as we head deeper into the season. You know, see some teams we're not as used to playing. And actually, that's an interesting point. Let's take a look at the Badger calendar here while we've got a second. So the next game, Panthers are on the road, and actually the rest of these games will all be at 7 p.m. Central. Next game's on the road, Thursday, September 4th at 14th at Wanakee. Then at home, Tuesday, September 19th versus DeForest. At home, Tuesday, September 26th versus Sun Prairie East. On the road, Thursday, September 28th at Milton. And then the Panthers end the season, two home games. Tuesday, October 3rd versus Fort Atkinson. And then Thursday, October 12th, versus Stoughton. The way the Badger Conference handles your home and away games is a little interesting. So the Panthers are definitely loaded up on the home games this year. 7 home games, 3 away games. I think it flips next year. So if you like OCA Media, make sure you get your fill this year because you'll only get 3 games next year. That serves out of bounds. Panthers get the point. With the middle exchange, libero exchange. Sophie Tsai rotates into the front row. McKenna Carroll takes a seat. Alexis Fields back to serve. Field serve has been aggressive and challenging so far this year. Blocked by the Panthers, drops on the Beaver Dam side. On the line, Sophie Tsai with another block. Not a big resounding block that time, but it counts just the same. Alexis Fields back to serve. Panthers pull within three.
So if you can tell me, I do not play volleyball whatsoever. What makes her serve so difficult?
Yeah, well, one thing is watch where she serves. So she didn't serve at a player. She served what we call in the seam. She served in between two players. And one simple thing that does is it makes two players make a decision. Sophie Tsai with the quick and the kill. Panthers add another point. So then we'll see. Last time, Alexis Fields served between number 10 and number 6. So she served that seam and made them make a decision about who's going to take the serve. And now let's see if she serves to a different location on the court. I'm not saying she will, but that would be one way that you would see challenge. Nope, kind of served to the same place. She thinks number 10 is having a tough night at the line, so she's going to keep serving her. Set to Maya. That one, there was a block touch. Ava sets outside to Evie Lavoie. Through the block, 20 picks it up. 10 with the roll shot. Greta picks it up. Evie Lavoie brings it back. The Panthers are not going to be able to advance that one, but good hustle to bring it back. So the ways you might make your serve challenging is really to change it up. So, you know, if you serve a really driven hard ball, maybe the next ball is softer and shorter. Maybe you serve to a different seam. Another thing you'll do is called a float serve, which kind of moves around. We can't really see it from this angle, but if you're behind the court. Sophie Tsai with the quick and the kill. And actually, the next time Ava, number 5, serves, she's got a really challenging serve because she moves it around so much. So you can pay attention to that in three rotations. Rachel Cook is back to serve. She also has had a really challenging serve. Panthers are relatively good at the service line. Another thing you want to look at is the outcome on the opposing side. Is the setter able to stay comfortable with the pass? In this case, no. That's a double. So if the setter is able to stay comfortable and stand right where she's standing and really set anywhere she wants, probably wasn't that challenging of a serve. If the setter's really got to move and run and get that ball or pass with her platform, which means bump it. Oh.
Caught some nets.
Yep. Rachel Cook not able to keep the serve going. Beaver Dam up 2-7-9. Amaya Jackson back to serve. Sophie Tsai on the, Sophie Tsai on the slide. Hit into the block. Cover really wasn't there to help her out. So even though it wasn't a really, you know, a hard-driven block, Panthers were not able to recover it. Oh.
Here's number 10, Anaya Jackson is here to serve.
Yeah, and those really are not that challenging of serves, but they were giving the Panthers trouble. Evie Lavoie with the cross-court swing finds the wood. Panthers down 3-8-11. Dev Howard subs in, replaces Evie Lavoie, and will go back to serve. And that's tough. Middle number 12, Kendall Fakes, decided to step up and take that ball and serve receive. Fortunately, didn't give her setter really a good chance to play it. Emma Jolke. Get down. Another tough serve. Sobrulski passes it up. Free ball coming over. Panthers can run what they want. Sophie Tsai. hits it to the middle of the court. Sobrolski able to get a hand on it, but not able to pass it up effectively. Panthers pull within one, 10-11 here in set number two. That one's tough. Oh, come on. Just pokes it over. Panthers not really in position to recover that. Sobrolski back to serve. Lead sticks at two. That was a tough play. JC Andrew, where she took the ball, decided to set her middle. But her middle was right in front of her, I think. And so that ball coming over your head is a really hard ball to track and then hit with any kind of pace. Sophie Sy did a good job to get that one in. It was a nice serve by Sophie Sy. Whoa! Greta did what she could to keep that one in play. It's good to stay aggressive. That one just about hit the back window, though. Sophie Sy's having a good year at the service line. Last time I checked, she was up to 15 aces. That one's out. All right, so we're going to see Ava Dibovic-Skripka replace JC Andrew. Maya Rudy will replace Rachel Cook. And I hope I'm not jinxing her, but let's watch Ava serve because I think she's also had one of the more challenging serves to return this year. And if she serves more than once, let's see if she moves it around and attacks different points of the court. So there's a float. Definitely put the player in a tough spot.
Oh, blocked by.
But out of bounds.
Oh, dang.
It was nice to get up there and send it back. But like I was saying earlier, the Panthers have been working on making sure they frame the block so that when the ball hits you, it goes back into the play. And in that point, that time it didn't. It went out of play. Point for Beaver Dam. And we won't get to see Ava serve again. You'll just have to believe me, Ben. Ava sets Maya. Tip picked up by the Golden Beavers. Set her out, Dev Howard. Bump sets to Greta Schriever, who takes the swing. Block is able to get a touch, sets the middle. And that one gets over. Leads up to three. Kara Sanders back to serve. Good eye. Ooh. Alexis Fields called that one right away, knew it was going out. Boy, it felt like there was really good energy between both teams, like pretty even for the first 15 points, and then the Panthers just took off in set number one. Set number two, the Panthers feel kind of disjointed. They're not really putting points together in bunches.
Panthers' confidence at the absolute start of this was just extremely high. They were coming out of the locker room. They were all extremely hyped. They were looking forward to a great game. Whoa.
That was the biggest swing we've seen out of Amaya Jackson so far tonight. Yes. Got the kill.
Yeah, but they were just so energetic, and I think that first set just might have not have been what they were looking for, and now we just got to get our heads back in the game and see what we can do with it.
Yep.
Oh.
Yep. Nicely placed by McKenna Carroll. She's up to, I think I said this earlier, 14 blocks or 15 blocks already this year. One of the things that's so fun about watching McKenna Carroll play is she is always looking to score up at the net. If there's an overpass, she's going to go up. She's going to swing at it. Get down. She's going to go try to push it. Nice play by the Panthers to bring that one back. That's going to be tough to play. No, that didn't get over. Yep. So no touch by the Panthers. So that's four on Beaver Dam. Panthers pull within one. Alexis Fields back to serve.
See if you can tie this one up.
Thank you. The Panthers block have been sending a lot back. The Golden Beavers have not had too many clean swings where they set and they hit it over where they want to hit it. The block has been up there.
Yeah, especially with a player like Anaya Jackson. She's been really trying to get down on that ball and just see what she can do with it and see how far she can send it over.
Whoa. And on a roll shot, she has her second most effective swing of the night to put the Beaver Dam Golden Beavers up one again. Gabby fakes. Replaces Jalen Dronick and will serve. Alexis Fields, Greta Schriever, and Evie Lavoie back to receive. Whoa, way outside. Put Sophie Sy in a tough position. Not able to put a swing on that ball and then pushed down by Beaver Dam. Push the lead to two. Evie Lavoie bangs that one off the block. Golden Beavers not able to return it for an attack. Panthers pull within one again. And with a setter swap, JC Andrew into the front row. Rachel Cook back to serve. Another reason they have JC in the front row is she's very offensive minded. She's always looking to score. And she's got a setter dump that she likes to use, and she likes to go up and try to block the ball or tip the ball down. And so having her in the front row allows her to do that more freely. Not able to get the block on that one.
That one looked difficult.
Yeah. Well, and that's Abaya Jackson, the senior outside hitter from Beaver Dam, having a good night so far. I do not know what's going on with this serve. It does not look like it's that challenging from up here, so maybe there's something going on with it. Beaver Dam pushes the lead to three, and Coach Grokey takes a timeout, her first of set number two. Let's also take a moment to thank our financial sponsors who helped make this broadcast possible. The Village of Oregon, a great place to live, work, and play. The Oregon School District. Actively building competency, character, culture, and community. The Oregon Athletic Booster Club, supporting student athletes in all Panther sports. Be a part of something great. And Culver's of Oregon, Stoughton Health, J.L. Richards Prime Meats, Hy-Vee Grocery Store, the Oregon Area Cares Community Coalition, and Pizza Pit. Because of sponsors like that, we're able to bring you great programming like this event on OCA Media Sports. Okay, looks like that's the second timeout of the set for the Panthers. That's their last timeout of set number two. Greta Schriever with the pass to JC. Swing by Sophie. Beaver Dam able to dig it. Setter dump picked up by Sophie. Evie Lavoie with the tip, out of bounds. Panthers have got to change the trajectory here of this set. Ten's been at the service line a long time.
All right, Jackson with a good looking serve, but that's going to be out.
Nope, it is in. That is an ace.
Oh. Apologies there.
And that's what I meant by changing it up. So one serve goes to the back line. The next serve. Sophie with the quick attack. And the second touch puts it down. Panthers get a point. Dev Howard will sub in and go to the service line. Panthers looking for a little energy here at the end of set number two. Get back into it.
You have do you know how many aces Dev Howard has this year? Or?
No, I did not write that down. I'll have to think about it for next time. Oh! Ooh. Set or dump.
That's me, a double touch.
Yep. Greta got in kind of a tough spot on that tough pass. Just tried to bump it over. Beaver Dam getting close to the end here. Set number two. Dev Howard with the nice pass. Quick set to Sophie. Finds the back line. Panthers still breathing here. And Sophie Sy goes to the service line. One of the more effective servers on this Panthers team. Let's see what she can do. Panthers currently down four here in 19-23. And she aced him.
That ball just died in the air. Yep. That was awesome.
Well, now, so you saw where she served it. Let's see where she serves the next one. You know, because they're looking now. Well, they should be looking for a short serve. So you push it.
Yep.
Right at 10. That's over. Greta Schriever took a swing on that one, not able to put it down. That's a tough ball. She pushes it to that corner.
Oh.
Catches him napping. Panthers with another point, 21-23.
Anaya Jackson attempted to go for that one, but
Beaver Dam needs a timeout. So Panthers so far have done what they were looking to do here once they got to this rotation.
If your organization would like to join our group of sponsors who make Panther Sports possible, please contact Paul at ocamedia.com for more information.
And if you're enjoying watching Panther Sports on OCA Media, please consider supporting our nonprofit organization. With your help, we can continue to provide our viewers throughout Dane County with quality programming like this. Please visit our website for more information, ocamedia.com. All right, when we come back, Panthers are down 2-21-23 here in set number two. They took the first set 25-20. Sophie Sy's back at the line. One of the more consistent and reliable servers. Of course, never say that out loud right before someone serves. Sophie Sy, that's another ace.
Bound.
Panthers pull within one.
Wow.
22-23. One if you so now Sophie Sy served to three different spots with three different paces. So if you're Beaver Dam, you don't know where this fourth set's coming, or serve, I mean.
Yeah.
Drops that one short. Panthers are able to pick it up. JC Andrew sets it outside to Greta.
Oh.
No touch. So that will give Beaver Dam the point and bring us to set point. Alexis Fields replaces Sophie Sy with the libero exchange. Emma Jolke back to serve for Beaver Dam. Set point. Dev Howard. That one's off the line. Greta Schriever with the swing. Blocked. And that one falls. Beaver Dam takes set number two. 22-25.
Sophie Sy, her serve has just been crazy because she has been picking the right spots every time. She's been able to put it in between three and four people, and it's
yep.
worked out great for every time.
Yep, definitely moving it around. Unfortunately, not able to come up with enough enough points to avoid the set number two loss.
Yes.
So with the Panthers and the Golden Beavers tied 1-1, we've got a couple of minute break here before set number three. Ben and I are going to step away, and we'll be back in a few.
And we are back with 20 seconds left of this break. And so far this game's been going very interesting. Oregon has, I believe, they each have one set one? Yep. One set. Just so far it's just been such a interesting game with how it's been playing out. We've seen everybody get the rotations in so far. Well, almost everybody. And like you've said in the past, their serves are perfect almost. Like, they are putting them in the right spots. And then Beaver Dam, Anaya Jackson has been doing some really good work up in front and in the back. So, you got anything to add?
Yeah. Like you said, Anaya Jackson from Beaver Dam is having a good night. She's put down good swings, playing well in the back row. She ended up with a really long set of serves there in set number two. From where we sit, they didn't look that challenging, but, you know, maybe they were dropping out of the sky or had a funny spin on them. But either way, she scored a bunch of points for the Golden Beavers. We head here into set number three, Beaver Dam with the serve. Alexis Fields with the receive. Quick set to McKenna Carroll. Beaver Dam able to pick it up, set her out. Maya Jackson pushes it over. Panthers got a free ball it over. Jokey sets. McKenna Carroll with the big solo block in the middle. And that was interesting. So if you saw, they had a couple of hitters approaching the net, and the idea there is to confuse the defense about where is the ball going to go.
Yes.
McKenna Carroll was keyed in on number 10, Amaya Jackson, and solo blocked her, just blew it up. Great play. Greta Schriever back to serve. Nice swing by Addison Dow, junior middle hitter for Beaver Dam.
Alexis Fields was just a second late, and you know, that happens in all sports, and there's not really much you can do to prevent it. It's just sometimes that ball's going a bit too fast than you're ready for.
Yeah. Yeah, or you read one thing and they hit slightly differently, so you're out of position.
Yeah.
Alexis Fields with the receive. Ava sets up Maya Rudy. No touch. So that's out of bounds. Point number, Beaver Dam.
Number 14, Addison Dow to serve.
That one's in trouble. Beaver Dam's going to have trouble bringing that one back. They had to run around the line judge.
Evelyn Lavoie has been hitting that perfect spot where they're not seeing it coming, and it's just been working out great for her. So
yeah,
she's only a sophomore.
She's having a good year.
Alexis Fields up to serve.
She had 15 kills coming into tonight, 1.7 kills per set.
Wow.
Alexis Fields puts it at
Jackson.
Jackson. Set her down. That one's up. Evie Lavoie pokes it over. Set her out. Libero bumps it over to Jackson. That one's dug by Alexis Fields. Whoa! Big block by the Panthers. Sophie Sion, Maya Rudy sent that one back. And that was two great digs by the Panther defense.
That just looked amazing from even up here. So
I didn't see who got the first one. This actually is our – so we've got a replay up here, but we don't really control it, and it's pretty far back. Point is, Panthers had two great digs on that play. Oh! Alexis Fields not able to bring that one in. We're tied up here early in set number three, 3-3. Beaver Dam with the serve. Gabby Fakes, senior, back to serve. Greta. Sophie Side bangs it into the block. Beaver Dam able to return it. Greta Schriever pushes it out to Maya. Pushes to the deep line. Set or dump picked up easily by Greta. Quick set to Sophie. Out of position. So she ended up just passing it over. And then Amaya Jackson hits the overpass.
And just like I was saying earlier, this is what I love about all sports. Like, you always see the teamwork come together, and we just saw that there. Everybody was in sync. We were all seeing what we wanted to see. Unfortunately, it just did not turn out.
That one's out. It's interesting with one of the line calls we had earlier in the game. Panthers might want to think about being a little, you know, not as forgiving. If it's close, take it. But Greta and Alexis were pretty confident that one was out, let it go, and they got the call.
Number four, Rachel Cook to serve. Nia Jackson. I'm confused, and you look to be just a bit too. Can you tell me what you think would happen there?
So I think what the Panthers thought happened is the ball hit the net outside the antenna, and so I think the Panthers were saying they didn't have a touch. It didn't hit Jackson on her way out of bounds. Evelyn Lavoy. Whoa, that's going to be tough. Pushes it into the block.
Got to get
Panthers
over.
Just got to send it over. Roll shot. Picked it up. Sophie Sy with the set. Evie Lavoy with the tip. And it drops. So I think what the Panthers thought happened is it wasn't a legal attack. Hard to see from our angle whether it was outside the antenna or inside the antenna or whether it gets stuck in the net or touched the Panthers at all. Really hard for us to see. Actually, maybe this is it.
Yep.
I mean, it clearly got over the net and the Panthers touched it. And then maybe the Panthers thought the ball hit Jackson as she fell out of bounds. It didn't. I could see that clearly. So I think it was the right call. Boy, I think that ball was set to the offhand of the Beaver Dam hitter. So those turn into kind of change-ups. They come over a different speed than you're expecting. And so Panthers were there to block it, but it came out from a different angle and way slower than you expect.
Number four, Alexis with the one with the serve. Oregon keeps it in.
Yeah, that was a nice play. All right, Panthers playing good defense here. Greta Schriever with the roll shot. JC Andrews with the setter dump. Oh.
Kept it in.
Just got to pass it over. Panthers cover another setter dump. There we go.
Oh.
Long play, tough fought. JC Andrew goes up for the kill. And that's one of the reasons you have her setting out of the front row. You get into a weird position. She can jump up a swing. Like I said, she's always looking to score. She's going to find a way to get that ball down. Yep. Sophie Sy back to serve. We're tied up here. 6-6 in set number three. All right, Panthers scramble, bring that back. Sophie Sy free balls it over. Quick set to the middle. Oh, blocked, but the Panthers were not pressing over the net enough. Comes down on the Panther side. Point Beaver Dam. Emma Jolke for Beaver Dam is back to serve. Beaver Dam currently up one.
Sophie Sy just went out in for, I believe, Dev Howard.
That would be for the libero exchange. So Alexis Fields and McKenna Carroll replaced her. So McKenna goes to the front row, and Alexis Fields, number two, goes into the back row.
Okay.
And then the libero, the one in the different jersey, they'll always play in the back row. That's going to be an overpass. JC Andrew pushes it over.
Just like you said, she's always looking for that chance to make that point,
yep.
And that's been going on for a great tonight.
And another interesting rule is, so if you're in the back row, you cannot attack the ball above the net from in front of the 10-foot line, which is the line 10 feet from the net.
Yes.
But because JC sets from the front row, she can attack. If she had done that, oh, ace! If she had done that from the back row, that would have been an illegal play. And so when JC sets from the back row, it kind of takes away some of her tools. So let's see if Ava changes up. That was kind of a lollipop serve that fell in front. Now she drives it at him, right into a scene in between two players.
Oh,
McKenna Carroll trying with the solo block, not able to push it back. Point Beaver Dam.
Yeah, sometimes that communication key just does not go into play when you're trying to make the block like that. Maybe your teammates see it coming, but it's from a different angle or there's a nasty spin on it. Number six, Carol Sanders.
Kara Sanders. McKenna Carroll. McKenna Carroll, actually not with the kill. I think they called Beaver Dam in the net. But point Panthers either way.
Devin Howard is going to be out as Evelyn Lavoie comes in.
Yep, and Greta Schriever back to serve as we're tied up again, 9-9. Oh, my goodness gracious. Those are disappointing. That was a tough serve, forced him into an overpass, and then the Panthers were not in position to receive the overpass.
Number 14, Addison Dowd. Oh. Addison Dowd has been doing that same serve anytime she's been able to step up to that line, and obviously from up here and from a non-experienced player, I don't really see what's wrong with that, but I'm sure it's got something to it that we're not able to see up here.
Yeah, well, and that one caught Evie Lavoie high. And so she didn't have really strong hands, and it kind of played her.
Yep, looking at the replay, yep.
Panthers down three. We've been playing point for point, and Beaver Dam has gone on a little bit of a run right here.
So we're going to end that with the spike.
Yeah, Amaya Jackson with the good play at the net, and the Panthers need a timeout. OCA Media is your local community access television station, broadcasting current, entertaining, and informative programs on Charter and TDS Cable. Don't miss a single Panther broadcast. Subscribe to our YouTube channel today. Visit our website for a program guide and more information, www.ocamedia.com.
And if you guys are enjoying watching this, I know I think I can hopefully speak for Mike. We love doing this stuff. We love to announce, and our cameraman, who's usually not in the spotlight, Will, has been doing a great. I believe he's been doing a great job tonight, and we do try our best. So, if you guys do enjoy watching Panther Sports on OCA Media, please consider supporting our nonprofit organization. With your help, we can continue to provide our viewers throughout Dane County with quality programming like this. Please visit our website for more information, ocamedia.com.
Yeah, shout out Will. Keep it up. Panthers currently down four in set number two. We're tied one set apiece. Panthers took set number one, 25-20. Dropped the second set, 22-25. We had been playing point for point, but Beaver Dam's on a little bit of a run right here, and Panthers are looking to change the momentum. Evelyn Lavoie with the serve receive. Set outside to Maya Rudy. Roll shots it over. Set outside to Amaya Jackson.
Ooh,
blocked by the Panthers. Beaver Dam able to dig it. Ooh. Alexis Fields with the dig. Set outside to Evelyn Lavoie. No touch on the block. Point Beaver Dam. That's tough. That was a great play by Alexis Fields to keep it alive. You'd like to see the Panthers get that one over.
Number 14, Addison Dow.
Oh, Greta with the good get on that one. Come on, Evie. Pushes it to the corner. That's a lift. Tough play. She got into a tough spot. When you reach behind your head like that, you're going to get called.
Unfortunately.
All right, Panthers down four, 10-14. Alexis Fields back to serve. Panthers looking to get on a run. That's going to be a good start.
That is a great serve from Alexis Fields, right where you don't want it. You can't expect it to drop. You can't expect it to keep going. That's good job by Alexis Fields by keeping the defense guessing.
Yep, and served right on the line, so you couldn't let it drop. Set to the middle, blocked by the Panthers. Sophie Tsai and Evie Lavoie send that one back. Panthers pull within two. Alexis Fields back to serve.
Now I'd like to go back to your point. Let's see if you're going to choose maybe just a bit of a different spot to keep the defense guessing.
Yep. Picked a different seam. Oh, jeez Louise. Roll shot right to the middle of the court. Panthers not in position to return it. They make up a little ground. Down three, 12 to 15. Gabby fakes.
She's also been serving really great tonight, too.
Yeah, back to serve.
Alexis has a good save there. Let's see if he can get it back in the middle over the net.
Nope, that was the fourth contact.
That was fourth, okay.
It was a nice play by Alexis to bring it back, but unfortunately had a little bit too much mustard on it. Put it into an angle where her teammate couldn't return it. Woo!
So I'm not going to lie, I don't know what it was called there. Maybe you think you can explain it for me and a couple of our viewers who might not know what happened
there.
Yeah,
it was a double on number five. So it was a weird pass, and so she took it at kind of a sideways angle. And so they said she had a double contact, which is illegal. Quick set to Sophie, and that one's down for the kill. I find those plays really hard to tell what's going on. It's hard for me to see which side of the net it went on, so I just see which team celebrates. All right, JC Andrew checks into the front row. Rachel Cook replaces Maya Rudy. Back to serve. Panthers need to make up some ground here in set number three. They've got time.
See if we can get JC Andrew behind that block again and see if she can keep looking for them.
There it is. Evie Lavoy and Sophie Sy this time send it back. Rachel Cook is back to serve. Get over.
Yes. Barely touched the net.
Oh, late double call. Ref thought about it a little bit and then decided to call it.
Which can especially be confusing to us up here because I know a lot about the game. But...
All right, Amaya Jackson back to serve. She put a handful of points up in the last set. Oh.
That looked like it hurt just a bit.
Nice pass.
Good block by Sophie Sy. JC Andrew is able to send it over. And then Evelyn Lavoy looks like she's going to try to get it.
Yep, that one didn't get over. Those are tough points going back and forth. Panthers are happy to win that one. And that'll send Dev Howard back to the line. Panthers currently down three.
That's
get down.
Nice serve.
There it is. Panthers down two. Picking up some steam here as we approach the final points of our third set. That's another one down. Panthers played some really tough matches this weekend. Oh, and that's going to be a timeout, Beaver Dam. So the Panthers played some really tough matches this past weekend at the Middleton Invitational. They won against Wisconsin Heights and Madison Memorial. And the Madison Memorial matches were really, they were really tough. They were well-matched teams. They were both fighting really hard. It was a really hot, loud gym. When you play tournaments, you don't play best of five. You play best of three. So they split the first two sets and then had to go into a third set. And like I think I was saying to you, maybe off mic, they ended up winning that third set 18-16. And so that's a bunch of extra points in the third set. And the Panthers were really excited to come away with that win. You have those tough matches, and I think those pay off later in the season. You know, the Panthers, they've been down. They've had to fight back. They've been, you know, they've been in loud gyms with kind of opposing fans. And so it's good. It can be good to have these experiences. It's fun to see the Panthers fight back. Now we want to see them not just fight back, but let's take the lead here. You know, let's keep going and take set number three.
Yeah, and as a person who's played many sports in the past, like, noise can be your best friend and your worst enemy at the exact same time, because sometimes it's the unexpected loudness of the gym that can just really throw you off there.
Dev Howard's pass serve goes out of bounds too long. Beaver Dam with a two-point lead.
Number four, Alexis, to serve. Dev Howard with the tap. That's going to end up going out of bounds.
Back to a three-point lead. Sobrilski back to serve. Oh, Sophie Tsai just able to send that one over.
That looks like Sophie Tsai to serve.
Yep, and with the libero exchange, Alexis Fields goes out, and McKenna Carroll's back into the front row.
Nia Jackson with that little tap that's going to end up set.
Oh! Dang it. You'd like to see Sophie Tsai get more chances at that service line. Unfortunately, Beaver Dam able to pound that one off the block and get the point.
Number 20, Emma Juka, up to serve. JCN, she's going to pop that one up, see if we can get it over.
Now it's trouble.
That was net, wasn't it?
Oh, yep, and they called it on the Panthers.
Oh.
On McKenna Carroll.
Shucks.
Kind of a tough call, I think. Hard for me to see up here exactly who touched it. They call JC Andrew on the double. Panthers need a timeout. Down five here near the end of set number three.
So we would like to welcome our local partners whose financial support helps make this broadcast possible. The Village of Oregon, a great place to live, work, and play. The Oregon School District, activity building, competency, character, culture, and community. The Oregon Athletic Booster Club, supporting student athletes in all Panther sports. Be a part of something great. Culver's of Oregon, Stoughton Health, J.L. Richards Prime Meats, Hy-Vee Grocery Store, the Oregon Area Cares Community Collection, and by Pizza Pit. So far, especially for this being one of my first times broadcasting a volleyball game, this game has looked really good from my end. Maybe we can get a bit more of a professional view from you.
I'm definitely an amateur, but I've watched a lot of volleyball in my day. I mean, it's two closely matched teams. Right now, Beaver Dam has had a bit more consistency and has been able to get on those scoring runs. You know, the Panthers had one near the end of set number one, but
Ben Howard, we need to get this one over.
Greta
Shriver. That's going to be out.
Yep. But otherwise, other than that, you know, the end of set number one, it's been Beaver Dam that's played with the consistency. You'd like to see the Panthers stay calm, come in with fire. Ooh. Greta Shriver gets that one over.
Can't save it by number 10, and Nia Jackson tries to save that one once more, but I believe that was their second, or was that their third hit?
It was their second. If she was able to pop it back, they would have had an opportunity, but she wasn't able to bring it back.
Now we have
Ava Dibovic-Skripka. Dibovic-Skripka. Out. No touch.
Got Oregon on that.
Yep. Panthers have good servers all over this team. This is one that you're happy is back at the line. Ava can definitely drop four in a row. Get down. Oh, Alexis Fields gets a hand on it. Panthers not able to recover. Beaver Dam takes set number two, 2025. Panthers take set number three, 2025. So now the Panthers will need to regroup. And Ben and I will step away and let you enjoy our Panther dance team.
Great. We are back from our break. If you guys saw, Oregon cheer was doing fantastic out there. We got what appears to be a very interesting game, and we're just trying to make sure that Oregon can really pay attention, because this could be our last set, and so we really have to put up our A game, and we really got to just start. Get back on those lines, I guess. We got to, maybe from your view, it's a bit different, but that's at least for me.
Yeah. Panthers took set number one, and then Beaver Dam took sets two and three. They've all been hard fought, 25-20, 22-25, 20-25. Panthers have had flashes, but really, when they're scoring lately, it's been point for point with Beaver Dam, and they need to go on a couple runs. Ava back to serve. Service has been good.
That is. Jordan Elsner, I think this might be her first appearance in the game.
Greta Schriever, oh, what a dig. Oh, Greta Schriever goes to push to that back corner, but it hits the antenna. So those candy cane looking things, if the ball hits those, it's out. And so when Greta pushes over and hits that antenna, it's out right away. Plays over. Doesn't matter what happens after that.
Now we have number six, Kara Sanders up to serve. Serves looks good from out here. Got number five, tap it.
Oh, so that was the set was not timed right, or the swing wasn't timed right. But McKenna Carroll was able to hang up there, poke it with her offhand for a tip, and get the kill.
Oregon and Beaver Dam are now tied 1-1.
And you had good eyes, Ben. That is Jordan Elsner. Checked in on the right side, number 16. She typically comes into play when the Panthers need a little bit bigger block. So she, I believe, will be playing for Maya Rudy this set.
And then I can also see Evelyn Lavoie, I believe that is, along in with Jordan. I think that... This might be a tallest squad. I'm not sure.
Yep. Oh, Jordan with the swing in the middle. Not able to get on top of it. And actually, it looks like McKenna Carroll is swinging from the right side. So Jordan is swinging from the middle. I had it backwards. McKenna Carroll and Sophie Sy switch. So we'll see where Jordan swings now that Sophie Sy is in. Alexis Fields back to serve. Yes.
Good tap. Good block.
Big block out of bounds.
Jordan Elsner and Sophie Sy with the block.
Yes.
Those, especially Sophie Sy, has been helping us a lot tonight.
Yep. Unfortunately, that one went out of bounds, so it's still a point Beaver Dam.
But I must admit, that is quite impressive.
Yeah. Gabby fakes back to serve. Sophie Sy with the tip picked up by Beaver Dam. Jordan and Sophie able to slow down the ball on the block, but not able to cover on the Panther side. Point Beaver Dam.
I can't tell from up here who tapped that when the serve came in, but looked pretty good both ways, so.
Oh, man. Sophie Sy goes up to take the second attack.
Good block.
Set her out. Greta Schriever steps in. Sets Evelyn Lavoie. Pushes it to the middle of the court. Beaver Dam able to recover.
Lex Fields. Out again. Evelyn Lavoie's going again.
Oh. And that's another kind of tough one where she sent it to her outside, but it was coming a bit over her head. Those can be tough to time and tough to, you know, catch up to it and really put a swing on it. Fortunately, she hits it into the net. It's Point Beaver Dam. They're up 3-5-2 here in set number 4. This is a must-win set for the Panthers if we want to keep playing. Jordan Elsner hits that one. It hits the antenna. That's out. Panthers kind of stuck in this rotation right now. That one's on the line.
Just like you said earlier, we really got to be watching that. We got to be watching the line. Like, they've been calling it real close, and obviously we can't see from up here, so there's probably a much different view down at the court, but we really got to be really defensive about that. We got to think, okay, is this clearly over my head? Yeah. Oh, it's not? Let's see where it goes.
We've got a sub on the Panther sideline as Jada Anderson steps in to replace Greta Schriever. She's a senior on this team who comes in and adds some defensive spark when players need a breather. Evelyn Lavoie not able to get the attack in. Sophie Sy with the tip. Just bitten. Three tough points in a row there where Panthers not able to get a good attack on the ball.
Timeout by
down
Oregon.
Early in set number 4.
I believe that was timeout by Oregon, correct?
Yep.
This game has just been all around confusing, I think is the word I'm looking for. You look at all of the servers that we've had. You looked at all of the people up in the front that have been making some absolutely great sets possible, but we've also been really lacking in a few areas. From my view, I do think that our defense has been just a bit, like, off. Like, we have not had as good of communication on the court as I think we could have.
Well, and Beaver Dam is continuing to play and put the ball over. Panthers have had a couple of plays where their hitters were in, you know, maybe an uncomfortable position and not able to get a good swing on the ball. It's good to stay aggressive. Unfortunately, we've had a bunch of tough points in a row. Panthers find themselves in a bit of a hole. It must win set number 4. Beaver Dam serving up 7-9-2.
Number 6, Jada Anderson just helped with that play, and Oregon let that one slip right by us, which is really unfortunate.
Yeah, Sophie was able to get up on a joust and send it over, but Beaver Dam was able to recover. And then on the next joust, Beaver Dam was able to push it to the side, get the point on the Panthers.
See if we can take this one back right here. Jordan Elsner with it going over. Alexis Fields with the save. Jordan Elsner going over again.
Oh. Hit into the block.
Score is currently 2-11. Beaver Dam leading.
All right, Greta Schriever checks back in. Replaced Jada Anderson, who gave the Panthers a little bit of extra passing in that back row.
Sophie Sy
hits into the block. Beaver Dam able to recover. Jordan Elsner goes for the block, unfortunately out of bounds off her.
So while we have a quick second, is there anything you can do to possibly make, like when you see that block going up, is there anything you can do to make it a lot harder to block, like maybe hit it just a bit harder, maybe aim in a different spot? What is there?
One of the things you can do is use the block to your advantage. You can hit off the block. There we go.
There you go.
Panthers with the point. So if you see a big block, what you can do is instead of hitting like you're going to hit to the court, you can plan to hit off the block and hit it out of bounds off the block. Or another thing you can do is when the block is there, they call it high hands, hit off the top of their hands. And so maybe you're having a different angle. It maybe if they weren't there, it wouldn't go in. But with the big block up there, if you hit off the top of their hands, you can send it out the back, make it tougher to recover.
Now we have J.C. Andrew and Rachel Cook in for Ava. Can you put that last name, please?
Dibovic Skripka.
Thank you. And then Jordan Elsner.
Evie Lavoie with a big swing. Unfortunately, that one is into the net. Beaver Dam with the serve. Panthers down 10, 3-13 here in set number four.
Anaya Jackson up. Sophie Sy. Blocked.
J.C. Andrew with the setter dump.
There you go, blocked again by J.C. Sophie Sy with it over.
Ooh. Oh, that's a tough call. It looked up from here, but they called it down.
Oh, you got that point. Good.
Yep.
So while they're retrieving that, while they're retrieving the ball, makes that really difficult.
They called net.
Oh.
On Beaver Dam, I think.
Okay. Let's find out. Devin Howard with it coming in.
Hard to see whether there was someone in the net there.
It is.
Good pickup by Dev. They run the slide for Sophie. She tips it over. Beaver Dam picks it up. Free ball coming over. See if the Panthers can use it.
Dev gives it right to oh.
Sophie Sy.
Net, maybe. Oh, no.
Nope. Doesn't get over the net, so no touch on Beaver Dam. Four contacts on the Panthers.
Now we have number four, Alexis Sobrowski. I keep on messing that one up, unfortunately.
Yeah, Sobrowski.
Sobrowski, thank you.
Dev Howard attempts the receive.
Come on, Oregon. Let's see if we can win this one back. Alexis up to serve again. Alexis with the dive. Sophie Sy is able to send it over. Number 19, Anaya Jackson bumps it. Alexis again sets up.
Oh. Greta Schriever with the kill. Unfortunately, we haven't seen much of that tonight.
No.
That was a nice swing by Greta.
That was
point Panthers.
Yep, that was well needed, though. Now we have Sophie Sy stepping up to the service line.
Yeah, Panthers are going to need something special to climb back into this match.
There you go.
Sophie, nice defensive play. Greta tips and it's out. Point Beaver Dam.
Now we have number 7, Gabby Fakes, going out. And we have number 16, Jalen Dzornik. Do you have that one down?
Dronik.
Dronik. coming in. So, have you seen her? Have you seen her play yet today?
Yeah, I think we have. Okay. She's one of their starting middles.
Okay. Number 20, Emma Juka with the serve. JC Andrew puts it right up in dice.
There we go.
Piece of wood.
Greta with another kill.
We've been waiting for that. Score is now 6 Oregon, 16 Beaver Dam. It's weird. We keep on trading points. Let's see if maybe we can get on a decent run here.
Yeah, and we're going to need either a really big run or a couple small runs, and Panthers are running out of time here in set number 4.
Oh, yeah, number 6, Jada Anderson.
So no, that's Ava.
Oh, sorry.
All right, free ball coming over.
Oh, Alexa saves it, and that's going to be third tap.
Yep.
Fortunate. It seems like we've been finding ourselves in that kind of predicament a few times.
Yeah, it's a tough night. Tough night out there for the Panthers right now.
We got number 6, Kara Sanders, up to serve.
Yep.
Dev out with the tap. Looks like it's going to go up. Set her up nice. Finds piece of wood there as well.
Wait. Oh, they called Greta on the net.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Someone was in the net, but I couldn't tell if it was on the swing. Sometimes the ball hits the net on the swing. But in that case, they said she was in it.
Jordan Elsner is back in as well. Jeff Howard with the tap. Let's see if he can set it up one more time for Jordan.
Jordan with the nice swing. Beaver Dam able to recover.
And blocks not
big
possible.
Big kill out of the middle.
Yeah. Score keeps on not looking too good for the Panthers, but we're going to try to turn this around. Current score is 6 Oregon, 19 Beaver Dam. That's a tough one right there. It really is. Number 6, Kara Sanders up to serve again. Comes off of, I think, Devin Howard's knuckles. Is that what made that ball fly like that? Or?
Yep.
We can get this one back here. So
tough spot for Greta. Able to get the swing
there
and the kill.
There you go. That's well needed. Well needed. Well needed. See if we can get on a decent sized run here.
Dev Howard makes way for Evie Lavoie. Greta Schriever back to serve. Greta with the tough serve. Roll shot coming over. Alexis Fields picks it up. Set to McKenna, tips it over, picked up by Beaver Dam.
Hits the net. There you go.
Yeah, Oregon. Amaya Jackson with her first non-quality contact in what feels like an hour. If you're enjoying watching Panther Sports on OCI Media, please consider supporting our nonprofit organization. With your help, we can continue to provide our viewers throughout Dane County with quality programming like this. Please visit our website for more information, OCIMedia.com. Another kill out of the middle for Beaver Dam. That window is rapidly closing for the Panthers this evening.
Yep. That spot keeps on just getting more loose and more loose. I do feel like they've hit it there quite a few times, but obviously it's really hard because they're sending it over so fast. It's very hard.
Addison Dow. Addison Dow, 14, has done a good job swinging from the middle. Alexis Fields back to serve. Some point you take a look at this evening and, you know, you try to find the learning experiences the Panthers can build on later in the season.
I'm sure you just heard the sigh from me. Oregon is currently at 9. Beaver Dam's at 22.
Gabby Fakes back to serve.
Yep, like it was just said by Mike, our window is very, very soon closing.
Another ball drops on the back line.
It's getting tough. I feel like we're getting really, really picky when we shouldn't be. And we're just, I don't know what the proper word is, I'll be honest. So
Panthers go on the road on Thursday at Wanakee. So if you don't have plans, come drive to Wanakee and cheer on your Panthers. Oh, Panthers not able to connect on the set. And that brings up match point.
See if we can maybe stay alive here. And hit finds the piece of wood.
Oregon. Before we say good evening, we'd like to welcome our local partners whose financial support helped make this broadcast possible. The Village of Oregon, a great place to live, work, and play. The Oregon School District, actively building competency, character, culture, and community. The Oregon Athletic Booster Club, supporting student athletes in all Panther sports. Be a part of something great. Culver's of Oregon, Stoughton Health, G.L. Richards Prime Meats, Hy-Vee Grocery Store, the Oregon Area Cares Community Coalition, and by Pizza Pit. Pretty disappointing end of the evening, Ben. I'm glad you can join us. Panthers are going to have to figure out what was going on in that fourth set. They fought hard for three sets, and then in this fourth set, you know, it was some tough bounces, but also just a tough set.
It's just, like I've said plenty of times in the past, I'm no volleyball player. I'm not a professional, but we all come here to watch a good sporting event be played, and that's what we just witnessed here. Unfortunately, it did not work out for the Panthers tonight, but we're really hoping that we can defeat Wanakee this coming
Thursday on the road.
On the road. So, like Mike just shared, if you guys don't have anything going on Thursday, come support your Panthers Thursday at Wanakee, and we'll see if our practice on Wednesday, we can maybe find out what happened yesterday.
On behalf of the OCA Media Sports production crew, thank you for watching. This has been a presentation of OCA Media Sports. This is Mike Stapleman and
Ben Baker
saying good night.
Night.